Hello students, good morning.
Let's continue our chapter 4, that is Animal Kingdom. Yesterday we have studied about phylum Porifera. Now we will study the phylum Coelenterata. First we have to know the general characters of Coelenterata. What are its general characters? Why do it placed in the phylum Coelenterata? So its general characters are, first they are aquatic. Aquatic means marine or freshwater. Aquatic means those organisms who live in water bodies. So water bodies are of two types. One is marine, means salty water, and another is freshwater. So the species of coelenterates may be marine or freshwater, but maximum or most of the species belong from marine. Next, see how it is classified. Its body is bilaterally symmetrical, means it can be divided into two equal halves having one right and one left. Then it is diploblastic, means it has two germinal layers. One is ectoderm, means outer layer, and another is endoderm, means inner layer. Then again, its other characters are, it has tissue level of organization, means its body is consist of tissue. And the digestive system is incomplete, as I have discussed in our last class, that what is incomplete digestion. Incomplete digestion means if the organism possesses only a single pore or single opening for both taking food and releasing the waste. So that's why we can say that its digestive system is incomplete. Next, digestion is both intracellular as well as extracellular. Here intracellular means when digestion takes place inside the cells, it is called intracellular, and when digestion takes place outside the cell, that is called extracellular. So digestion is incomplete, may be intracellular or extracellular. Sometimes they bear corals. You know about corals, coral reefs, large islands seen in oceans and seas. So they form corals like a mountain. Looks like white. So these corals are made up of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. So their structure is so hard, as they are made up of calcium carbonate, so their structure is so hard. And some of them are cylindrical shape, like your hydrilla and adamsia. Remember the examples. Cylindrical shape is hydra and adamsia. Next, umbrella shape is Aurelia and jellyfish. I will draw the diagram and you see how they look. They show alternation of generation. In plant kingdom, we have studied alternation of generation, but here it means something different. Alternation of generation means metagenesis, means the species of coelenterates forms or shows two type of lives. One is polyp produces medusa when it reproduces asexually. Remember this line, polyp forms medusa. Medusa is a form, alternate form of polyp. Polyp forms medusa when it reproduces asexually, and medusa forms polyp when it is reproduced sexually, or vice versa. So this type of life cycle is called alternation of generation. So next is, they have stinging capsules. Why they are called Coelenterata or Cnidaria? As they have stinging capsules. Stinging capsules help them for catching prey and preventing them from the predators. That's why they contain stinging capsules, which you can say dunk marne wala. Dunk jo marta hai, that are called stinging capsules. Example of coelenterates are Portuguese man of work, which is called Physalia. You have to remember these examples. Physalia is biological name and English name is Portuguese man of work. Then Adamsia is the biological name and in English it is called sea anemone. Then Penacula, which is called sea pen. Mandrina is called brain coral. So these are the examples of phylum Coelenterata. Next, move to the next phylum, that is your Ctenophora. So let's see their basic general characters. What are the general characters of Ctenophora? Ctenophora are commonly called sea walnuts. They look like walnuts and they have tissue level of organization with diploblastic. Tissue level of organization means their bodies consist of tissues. Diploblastic means they have only two germinal layer, means one ectoderm and one endoderm. They are marine, means they live in oceans and seas or in salty water, and their body is radially symmetrical, means when we cut the organism's body into two planes, we get two equal halves. They are not distinct as right and left, but two equal halves we get. Digestion also, like the phylum of Cylindrata, digestion also takes place in two methods. One is intracellular and another is extracellular. Intracellular, I have already told you, when digestion takes place inside the cell, and extracellular when digestion takes place outside the cell. They are so bioluminescence. Bioluminescence means the living organism has light emitting property. This is the only phylum which contains the organisms who emits light, like stars. They emit lights, that's why the term is called bioluminescence. Their reproduction sexually occurs through fertilization, and fertilization is external. What do you mean by internal and external fertilization? Internal fertilization means when male and female gametes fuse within the female body is called internal fertilization, and external fertilization means when both the gametes, means male gamete and female gamete, fertilize outside the body, that is called external fertilization. So the species of your phylum, that is Ctenophora, so external fertilization, development is indirect. Listen, development is of two types, one is direct and one is indirect. When the organism reproduces and gives birth to the organism that is completely resemble with the parent species, that is direct development. And if the organism that is take birth from the parent makes or goes through any stage like larval stage and doesn't resemble with the parent, this type of development is called indirect development. So here the species of phylum Ctenophora shows indirect development, and the examples of it are Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. These are the examples, Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. As they are animals, so they have two long flagella and their structure is comb like. They are also, we can say as they are, these are called as complex. They are look like this. They have eight rows of columns found in the body of this species. So this is about your phylum Ctenophora, and your next phylum is, that is phylum Platyhelminthes. Next phylum is your Platyhelminthes. Again, consider its general characters. Its body is diploblastic. It is bilaterally symmetrical. They are called flatworms. Flatworms, and they are dorsoventrally flattened. Dorsoventrally flattened means this side is called ventral side and this side is called dorsal side. So they look like this. They are dorsoventrally flattened. Planaria is come under this phylum. So they are endoparasites. The species of Platyhelminthes are endoparasites, means they live inside the, I have told you, they may be marine, they may be freshwater. Some species are also live in terrestrial medium, and they are completely, some of them are endoparasite, means live inside the body of animals and plants, human beings also. As they are parasites, so they bear the organs for taking nutrition like suckers. So they have also high regenerating capacity, means as you know, in cabbage the worm that is found is called tapeworm. This is look like this tapeworm. It has high generating capacity, means when it cut into many pieces, this is also planaria. If it is also cut in many pieces, each piece has the ability to provide or to give many organisms. This is also, that's why we can say that they have high regenerating capacity. Fertilization is internal. internal fertilization means fertilization takes place inside the body of that organism and development is indirect. Development is indirect. As we see in the phylum Ctenophora, here is also the development is indirect, fertilization is internal. So the examples we can take here as pleuro, we can take it as tinea and fasciola. Tinea and fasciola are the examples. So this is your phylum Platyhelminthes.